Shalom, Israel. Shalom, shalom. It's that time again. Welcome. Spread the word. We're live with another episode of Did You Know? All right. Yeah. Big up Ahaya Designs for the merch. You with me? The name of Ahaya and the cap. Nice. Going through. And, you know, we have Kwame Asha Allah in the background as well. For them, you know, big up. All right. This evening, going to be another quick one again and some information that Elder Gabar sent to me over the week. So going into it, we're going to be touching today on a little bit of Mormonism, okay? Yeah, Mormonism. I mean, sometimes some topics come up within the church, right? And we always go, you know, we'll chuckle, we'll laugh about it, but sometimes we have to really, like, you know, just give a little breakdown of it, a little insight on it, so the people know where we stand as a church, and some things to look out for and not to get caught into deception. You know, hence these programs, Did You Know? I'm going to try and make this as quick and as easy as you know, to break down as possible. All right? So spread the word. We're here. Hit the like button. You know what to do. If you like it, hit the button. If you don't like it, hit the other button. Unfortunately, we don't have a flush button for you, but, you know, do your thing. You with me? It still spreads it. You all right? So check it. And we also live on Instagram as well. On GOCC144 on Instagram. So, yeah. Someone said, did you cut your hair? Yes, I did cut my hair. Anyways, gonna go into it right now. We're dealing with the church. We're dealing with the Church of Latter-day Saints or Mormons. Okay, now I'm gonna read some stuff here. Big up to Elder Gabar, like I said, that sent the information across. All right. So it says, check this out. Mormonism or the Book of Mormon. Okay. It says the Book of Mormon is based on the premise of two families of Israel escape from Israel shortly before the sacking of Jerusalem by Nebuchadnezzar, and that they constructed a ship, sail across the ocean, and arrive in the New World as founders of Native American tribes and eventually the Polynesians. So we know the Polynesians of you know, Hawaii and so on, going down to the islands, okay? Adherents believe the two founding tribes were called Nephites and Lamanites. So let me stop right there real quick. There's nowhere in the scriptures I can find any reference of Nephites or Lamanites, all right? Nephites, the closest thing I can find to the word Nephi or Nephi is Nephilim. And we know where that goes, all right? That the Nephites were white and practiced Christianity. So right away now, there's a distinction here. Good guys and bad guys. The Nephites or Nephites were white and practiced Christianity. Now check this out. I have a book here. All right. Looking at the tribe, the native tribe. See that? And you don't need to adjust your screen. You know, if it looks dark, yes, they were very dark. All right. Hope you can see it if you're on the Instagram and you're watching live on YouTube. They were dark. All right. This says, the Nephites were white and practiced Christianity, and the Lamanites were rebellious and received a dark skin from God as a mark to separate the two tribes. So when you look at this now, you see the dark skin. This is a curse from God. This is some of the teachings going on within the Book of Mormon. All right? And you can look this up. I'm not putting nothing out there that's not already there. Okay? It says here, eventually, the Lamanites wiped out the Nephites around 400 AD, leaving only dark-skinned Native Americans. So according to them, these are who were left. But anyways, the descent of Native Americans from Israel is a key part of the Church of Jesus Christ and Latter-day Saints' foundational beliefs. For example, Native American followers are almost always declared to be of the house of Ephraim when receiving patriarchal blessings, which support to reveal ethnic lineage. The Church of Latter-day Saints and Jesus Christ believe in the literal gathering of Israel, and the church actively preaches the gathering of the people of the 12 tribes. Now, the question about it is, who are these people that they're gathering? Because according to the Bible and archaeology, we know where some of the tribes went. Are they preaching to these people? Are they converting these people? Letting them know that they are the house of Israel and that they must return to the Most High, keeping his laws, statutes, and commandments? I don't know. You decide. Today, Israelites are found, and this is a quote from them. Today, Israelites are found in all countries of the world, Many of the people do not know that they are descendants from the ancient house of Israel. The church teaches in its basic gospel principle manual, the Lord promised that his covenant people would someday be gathered. God gathers his children through missionary work as people come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ, receiving the ordinance of salvation, keeping the associated covenants, they become children of the covenant. So it almost sounds like some level of replacement theology. And that's a quote from 3 Nephi 20:26. All right. It says here, the church also teaches that the power and authority to direct the work of the gathering of the house of Israel was given to Joseph Smith by, guess who gave Joseph Smith the authority, according to the teachings, to gather Israel. I'll read it again. The church also teaches that the power and authority to direct the work of gathering the house of Israel was given to Joseph by the prophet Moses, who appeared in 1836 in the Kirtland Temple. The Israelites are to be gathered spiritually first, then physically. What does that sound like to you? That's another replacement theology about spiritual Israel. Okay? They are gathered spiritually as they join the Church of Jesus Christ and Latter-day Saints and make a sacred covenant and keep sacred covenants. I mean, sacred covenants. The Bible talks about the laws at the Most High. Are they keeping the laws? But anyways, I'll keep reading here. He says, the physical gathering of Israel means that the covenant people will be gathered home to the lands of their inheritance and shall be established in their own land of promise. 2 Nephi 9 and 2. The tribes of Ephraim and Manasseh will be gathered in the Americas. The tribe of Judah will return to the city of Jerusalem and the area surrounding it. The 10 tribes will receive from the tribe of Ephraim their promised blessings. Okay, and that's DNC 1:33, 26-32. The physical gathering of Israel will not be complete until the second coming of the Savior and on into the millennium. Joseph Smith, Matthew 1:37. One of their main articles of faith, written by Joseph Smith, is as follows. We believe in the literal gathering of Israel and the restoration of the 10 tribes, that Zion, New Jerusalem, will be built upon the American continent. So they believe that New Jerusalem will be in America. That's an article of their belief. Check this. That Christ will reign personally upon the earth, and the earth will be renewed and receive its paradisical glory. Articles of Faith number 10. Check it out. Regarding Ezekiel 37 prophecy, the church teaches that the Book of Mormon is the stick of Ephraim or Joseph mentioned in the Bible. So, you know, when the Bible talks about the two witnesses, they believe that the Book of Mormon is actually one of the witnesses. Garbage. But anyway, you can look it up. I keep reading. The church teaches that the Book of Mormon is a stick of Ephraim or Joseph Smith of Joseph Smith mentioned that the Bible is a stick of Judah, thus comprising two witnesses for Yeshua or for Jesus Christ. The church believes the Book of Mormon is a collection of records of prophets of the ancient Americas written on plates of gold and translated by Joseph Smith, 1830. The church considers the Book of Mormon one of the main tools of the spiritual gathering of Israel. Isaiah 34:16 says, seek ye the book of the Lord and read. Okay? One last point on this, okay? It says there's a comparison between or a link between Mormonism and Freemasonry. Okay, check this. It says the relationship between Mormonism and Freemason began early in the life of Joseph Smith, founder of the Latter-day Saint movement, and his older brother Hiram and possibly his father were Masons, while the family lived near Palmyra, New York. Nevertheless, in the late 1820s, now for people who don't know history, in 1820, Negroes were in cotton fields being whipped, if you don't know. This was never intended for Negro people or people of color. Why? Because we're looking at the images and what they claim about these people are supposed to be a curse from God because of the skin color. So this was never ever meant for the real gathering of the children of Israel. Okay? you know, the Mormons talk, they need to go down and break down and restore the Reubenites in Australia, them who living on these reservations over there, living in some detestable, deplorable condition. Let's go restore them. All right, let me keep reading here. It says here, nevertheless, in late 1820s, the Western New York region was swept with an anti-Masonic fever. By 1840, however, Joseph Smith and several prominent Latter-day Saints had become Freemasons and founded a lodge in Nauvoo, Illinois, in March 1842. Soon after joining Freemasonry, Smith introduced a temple-endowed ceremony, including a number of symbolic elements that were very similar to those in Freemasonry. Smith remained a Freemason until his death. However, later leaders in the movement have distanced themselves from Freemasonry. In modern times, the Church of Latter-day Saints, LDS Church, holds no position for or against the compatibility of Masonry with the Latter-day Saints Church doctrine. All right? So, like I said, we might have to do a two-part on this because there's more out there. There's more, a lot more information there to cover. But I wanted to drop that because a lot of people we see going off with more going into this Mormonism, saying that, you know, it's authentic or it's right. Now, yes, the tribes in America are descendants of the lost of the 12 tribes of Israel, 100%. We believe that, of course. But do we believe that Joseph Smith is the prophet? No. The Bible says all the prophets prophesied to John. Anyways. I think that's probably all the time that we have today for another episode of Did You Know? Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, share, or even the dislike button. Yo, you choose, you be the judge. Go check the information out. Until next week, same time, blessings and love to you all. Shalom.